Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to start on a new freeform geode again, and this time I'm not going to have a hole in it, and this is by request of Valerie. She wanted me to try this and I liked it because I didn't try it before. So this geode is not going to have a hole. So I made a mold the same way as I did with the other ones. I use a acetate sheet and 100% tube silicon. And I taped it on an MDF board with some masking tape. And I let it dry, and now I can pour the first layer. So I already put some opal crystals in the middle. In some clear resin, so that they stay in place. So in the center there are going to be the crystals. And I'm placing them on the place where I want them with my steering stick. And now I'm placing some white crushed glass, because they are a little bit larger than the opals, and then you can also already get some depth. And what I want to try to do is that I have in different layers the opals and the crushed glass, so that I can build it up, and that way create the depth in the middle. And this is not going to be a table, because it's not large enough. It's about 30 by 55 centimeters. So not going to be a table. I need to think about how I want to display this one. And the other geode, the purple magenta one, I'm still waiting on the table legs. And when I get them in, I will also make a video of how I attach those table legs. So I'm pouring some Midnight Black of Lures all the way against the outer barrier. That's a very deep black, very nice. And with my steering stick I make sure that it's all the way against the silicon barrier. All the materials I'm using are listed in this video at the beginning, and also in the description box with the links where I buy it. So if you want to see that, then you need to check that out. Now I'm adding against and on top of the Midnight Black, I'm adding some glitter bits of the Cosmic Shimmer, and this is the Midnight Black. Oh no, the Midnight Sparkle. And this is a very nice aluminium of Resi-Tint Plus. And I'm pouring it, making a line all the way around against the black. And they can bleed into each other. I don't mind. I like that. And now a line of white, and this is this white of stone coat. And I'm going to use the colors black, silver, white, and some sparkle pearl of Color Obsession, and some platinum of Just Resin. And this is the sparkle pearl of Color Obsession. I'm going to make a line all the way around the opals and the crushed glass. So the center will be lighter and sparkly. And this is the platinum of Just Resin. And this is only the first layer, so it's all about laying those colors down. And in the second layer I'm going to add some details. But this can bleed into each other. I like that. And then I will see what I will do in the second layer. So very carefully I push the resin against each other, so that I don't have any gaps. And again a glitter line, and this is also from Cosmic Shimmer, the glitter bits, and in the color blue gunmetal. Sparkles a lot, but yeah, you all know I like sparkles and I like glitter, so also in this geode a lot of glitter. Again, a white line. And again, the aluminium of Resi10 Plus, very nice, and you can get very nice effects with this pigment. Again, some Midnight Black of Lares. And again some glitter, the same one I used on the outside. And for this geode I want to have thin lines. I also did that and didn't do that before. Yeah, and then I need to wait how it dries in a couple of hours, because sometimes it changed a lot. So yeah, we will see. Also a glitter line against the aluminium of razor tint. And I don't think it will shine through, because it are all opaque colors except for the sparkle pearl of Color Obsession, but the rest is all opaque. So yeah, I don't think it shines through, but we will see when I have it out of the mold how it looks. And also some sparkle pearl against the white of Stone Coat. Yeah, and in the middle part where the crushed glass and the opals are, that also will shine through. But I don't think the rest will. So almost done with the first layer. Again, I'm pushing with my steering stick the resin against each other, very carefully. Also, at the end of this video, a close-up video after a couple of hours of drying. Then you can see if it changed or not. But yeah, then you need to wait until the end of this video. Again, some glitter all the way around. And that will be very subtle, because the black is very dark, deep, deep black. But I like it when you can see some sparkle in it. Some heat for the air bubbles. Not too much. Yeah, in the next layer I will be adding some details, what I already told you all, and also again some glitter and maybe some nice mica flakes. And I'm going to build up that center part where the opals and the crushed glass is. So this is how it looks after 4 hours of drying. A little bit of a shame that the sun doesn't shine, but okay. I have my lamp on my phone on, so that I hope you can see the sparkle. And it changed. And I think a lot, because all the black on the outside is still there. But I also made some lines of black more against the inner barrier, and that is almost gone. But I like it a lot, it's very sparkly. And also the aluminium of Racer Tint is very nice. There you can see the sparkle in the black. And it's also holographic. See, all the black is almost gone. I only have a small line, but I like that. It gives a nice contrast. So I need to think about what I'm going to do in the second layer. There you see the small opal crystals and the crushed glass. So this was the first layer. And if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up. If you like this video, if you have comments or tips or questions, please place them under the video and or send me an email. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye!